All right, so now I'd like to show you a large collection and the effect that indexing can have on performance. Now, our collection of tweets is relatively small, so instead we're going to revisit the OpenStreetMap dataset, which you should remember from a previous lesson. This will also serve as a nice transition to the next lesson, which is a project using the OpenStreetMap data. So for this example, I'm going to work in the MongoDB shell. And the database in which this data is stored is the OSM database. So I'll switch to using that. And then let's take a look at what documents look like in this database. And to do that, we'll just do a find everything. Okay, so then if we scroll up, we can see what these documents look like. There's location information, latitude, longitude. So all data in this collection is tied to a specific location. And something I'd like to point out is that some of the documents in this collection actually have a TG field. And this is shorthand for tag. So if you remember, we looked before at how specific locations will be tagged from time to time within this particular data set. And the way these tags work in this collection is there is a tag field that is array valued, and each of the individual values in this array are a subdocument with a K and V field, much like we saw in the XML version of this data set. Now, the reason why the data is represented this way is because there could be multiple taggings all with the same type or key. So storing them in an array this way gives us the ability to do that without one tag writing over another as we put them into MongoDB. One alternative would be to have this be a field name out here and this be the value for that field. Okay, now something I'd like to point out about this data set is that there are more than 7 million documents in this particular collection. Now, we've just talked about indexing and how indexes can improve performance. So let's take a look at a query and the amount of time it takes for that query to come back. Right now, I don't have an index on this tag field. So let's do a query and see what our performance looks like. Now, this particular collection that I've loaded here is actually all of the OpenStreetMap data from the city of Chicago, again. And what I'm doing here is querying for any nodes or any geographic locations that have been tagged with the name Giordano's, which is a famous Chicago pizza chain. So if we do this query, you can see that it takes a little while to come back. Let's do the pretty version of this query. Okay, so a couple of seconds, right, for the query to come back. So if we're doing a single query, not too big of a deal. But the fact is, in most applications, we're doing many queries. In some applications, hundreds or maybe even thousands or tens of thousands of queries in a very short period of time. So waiting 2 seconds for a query to come back, given the load that places on the database server, and all of those simultaneous queries going on at the same time, simply just doesn't work for our applications. It's death to our application, as I mentioned previously. So if we build an index on this collection, then our performance improves significantly, because instead of having to do a table scan, as we saw before, I can simply go right to the place on disk where these particular documents matching my query are located. Now, going too far beyond where we're already at with indexing is beyond the scope of this class. So I'm just going to essentially get you started with indexes here and encourage you to go look at the MongoDB documentation or take a look at the free online courses we offer on university.mongodb.com, see the instructor notes, for a comprehensive treatment of all of these topics that we've been discussing with regard to MongoDB, including indexing. Okay, so let's build my index. And the way I do this is by specifying the field on which I would like the index created. And I do this simply by saying, make it the case that there is an index on the field TG in the collection nodes. Okay, now, again, more than 7 million documents in this collection, so this is going to take a little while to come back. It's going to take a little while to build the index. Had we created the index at first, then as we were loading data into the collection, it would have been updated with each write to the database. But in this case, we're building the index after we've loaded all the data in so that I could work through this example. So we'll just skip ahead in the video to the point where the index is actually created. This is going to take a couple of minutes. Okay, so now with the index created, let's run that query again and look at the performance difference. It was immediate, really. We got back our documents right away. And so that illustrates the performance differences in using an index versus not using an index.